In this video, we'll try to understand how to draw shear force diagram and bending moment diagram in case of cantilever beam carrying uniformly distributed load. Now the arrangement for the beam is as shown over here. So there is a uniformly distributed load acting for a half of the span length, that is L by 2, from the free end. So AB carries a u.d.l of W kilonewton per meter, and we have to draw the shear force and bending moment diagram for this particular arrangement. Now the conventions that we are using for shear force diagram, they are upward forces, they are considered as positive, whereas downward forces, they are considered as negative. Now shear force at A will be zero because this is the starting point for the u.d.l. At B, it will be W multiplied by L by 2. Now, as it is acting in the downward direction, we have considered the minus sign. So it is minus W L by 2 kilonewton. Now, shear force at C will be same because there is no other load that is acting between B and C. So we can say that shear force at C is also equal to minus W L by 2 kilonewton. Now, we have to draw the shear force diagram. So we'll start with point A, it is zero at point A. At point B, it is minus WL by 2, remains same over the another length. So we can say that as it is below the baseline, correct, it is negative diagram, negative shear force diagram. So at A it is zero, at B it is minus WL by 2, and at C it is again minus WL by 2 kilonewton. Now we'll have to draw the bending moment diagram for this particular arrangement. For the bending moment diagram, first we'll convert this particular u.d.l into point load. So u.d.l is W kilonewton per meter, that is for 1 meter length the load that is acting is W kilonewton. Now this particular u.d.l is acting for L by 2 length, so W into L by 2 will be the total u.d.l length, and it will be acting at the center of this L by 2, that is L by 4. So we'll simplify this particular diagram. So our u.d.l load is W into L by 2 and acting at the center, that is L by 4. So we can say that this is our uniformly distributed total u.d.l which we have converted into point load. So it is W L by 2 and acting at half of this particular length or center of this L by 2, that is L by 4. Now the conventions that we have used for bending moment diagram, they are clockwise positive and anticlockwise negative. Bending moment at the free end, that is A, will be zero. Bending moment at B, now we have to consider this particular point load. So this point load is W L by 2 and the perpendicular distance is L by 4, and it will produce the anticlockwise moment about B, so it is negative. So minus W L by 2 into L by 4, so it is minus W L square by 8 kilonewton meter. Now bending moment at C, so again on the left hand side of C there is only this particular point load, so W L by 2, but the distance from this point up to point C will be L by 4 plus L by 2. Now L by 4 plus L by 2 is nothing but 3 L by 4, so we can say that it will be nothing but 3 by 8 W L square kilonewton meter. Now we'll draw the bending moment diagram for this arrangement. So again, all the values, they are negative. So bending moment at A is zero, bending moment at B is minus WL square by 8 kilonewton meter, and bending moment at C will be minus 3 by 8 WL square kilonewton meter. Now for AB length, there is a uniformly distributed load, so we have considered this particular negative parabola or inverted parabola, and then the straight line for the remaining part of the beam, that is BC. So in this way we can draw shear force and bending moment diagram in case of the cantilever beam carrying uniformly distributed load for half of the span length from the free end. Thank you very much for watching.